Morning all of you. This is chapter 8 comparing quantities, exercise 8.3, and this is question number 6. In this question it says, Arif took a loan of rupees 80,000 from a bank. If the rate of interest is 10% per annum, find the difference of the amount. Okay. Arif is taking a loan of 80,000. He took a loan of 80,000 from a bank at the rate of 10%, and you have to find the difference of the amount. First, you have to calculate for compounded annually. Second, you have to calculate for compounded half yearly. From the first portion and the second portion, you have to find out the difference in the amount. So first we will start with the compounded annually. So first it is written, for A portion I am writing, this is called compounded annually. Here the principal it is given as 80,000. Rate percent is given as how much? 10%. Time here it is given as 1.5 year. 1.5 year. So you know when the time period it is given as 1.5 year, for the 1 year we have to take out the compound interest. And for the half year, what we have to do? We have to take out the simple interest. Okay? So, here we have to take out for 1 year first and then for half year again. Then what we have to do? We have to take out the total amount for the compound interest also and for the simple interest also. So, let's start with the first year. For add for year, time is equal to 1 year. Compound interest, you know what is compound interest, you have to find out, that is amount minus principal. So for this, first we will take out the amount. Formula for amount is principal 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. Okay, what is the principal given to you, is 80,000. Write down 80,000. 1 plus rate is given as 10 upon 100 to the power, and time rate here it is given for 1 year. So this is 1. So from here 80,000, this 0 and this 0 will get cancelled. If you take out the LCM, it will become 11 upon 10 to the power 1. After this, what you have to do? 80,000 into 11 upon 10. This 10 and this 10, this 0 and this 0 bit cancels, and you will be remaining with 88,000. This is amount for 1 year, that is 88,000. Okay. Now this was for the 1 year. Now again, what is remaining? We have for half year. What we will find out? We will find out the simple interest. So time here is half year. Simple interest, you know what is simple interest here? That is, formula for simple interest is B into R into D by 100. This is the formula here. Substitute the value here. What is? So for second portion, we have to take out T equal to half years. So for this, if I take out the principal year, rate and time. So the principal for this will not be the principal for this time, because after 1 year the principal will be the amount taken out here. So the principal for T time for the half year will be 8,800. Okay, this will be the principal for this, and rate will be the same. Time will be half. Now you have to take out amount is equal to P into R into T by 100. Your principal is 88,000 into 10% into 1 upon 2 multiplied by 100. This zero gets cancelled, this 0 and this 0 gets cancelled, 2 1s are into 5s are. When you will multiply, you will get the amount here as 4,400 rupees. Okay, so this was for compounded. This amount was for 1 year, and this amount was for the the total amount. So total amount will be this added plus this. 8000. This much plus 4400. When you will add this, you will get 292400. This is the total amount. Okay? That you have compounded annually. This is the total amount compounded annually. Okay? Now what we have to do? We have to find out the compounded half yearly, and after that we have to find out the difference is the amount. Now we have to find it for compounded half yearly or annually. We have taken out this is this much. Now we will take out it for half yearly. Okay, for half yearly the principal year it is given as 80,000. Again, what is given? Rate. That is 10% and time is equal to 1.5 years. Now this is for half yearly. As you know, for half yearly the rate is divided by 10 and the time is multiplied by 2. So this is 2 ones are 2 and 1 is 3 by 2 and this will be multiplied by 2. Rate will be divided by 2 and time will be multiplied by 2. So this will be 5% rate and this will be 3 years. Now what we have to take out? We have to take out the amount first. For compounded annually, we have to take out the amount first. So what is the amount? What is, if the interest, you have to find out difference in the amount. So we will calculate the amount. Amount is equal to P 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. What is the principal? 80,000. 1 plus R is 5 upon 100 to the power 3. This is 5 ones are, 5 twos are. This will be 80,000. On solving you will get 21 upon 20. Nothing is there, means 1 is there. Okay. So to the power 3. So this will be 80,000 into 21 upon 20 into 21 upon 20 into 21 upon 20. This 0, this 0, this 0, this 0, this 0, and this 0. Okay, so on solving this, you will get 92610. You will get the amount for this is 92610. This is for half yearly. Compounded half yearly. Now, what you have to find out the difference in both. So, for compounded annually, it was this much, and for compounded half yearly, is this much. What you have to take out the difference? This is 92610 minus 92400. Subtract, you will get 0120000. So this is the difference in the amount. Okay, this is the difference in the amount to be compounded annually and to be compounded half yearly. This is question number 8 of exercise 8.3. This question, it says find the amount and the compound interest. You have to find the amount also and compound interest. Is compound interest on 10,000 rupees for 1.5 years. Rate is given you as 10% per annum. It is first is compounded half yearly. Second, would this interest be more than the interest he would get it was compounded annually? Means here in the question it is asking, first you have to take out it for half yearly, compounded half yearly. And second, you have to find it for compounded annually, and you have to find out would this interest be more than interest he would get it was compounded. You have to find out if the interest you get it for half yearly and for annually, which one is the greater one. So first for half yearly we will take out. So for half yearly taking it out for the half yearly first. So for half yearly, compounded half yearly, principal year it is given as 10,000, time year it is given 1.5 years, rate it is given as 10%. As you know, for half yearly The rate is divided by 2 and the time is multiplied by 2. So the fall, this is 3, 2 ones are 2 and 1 is 3 by 2. I said here in time you will multiply it by 2. So this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. You will get time here as 3 years. Similarly, for rate is divided by 2. That is 10 by 2, that is 5%. What you have to find out? You have to find out the amount first. So amount is equal to what? Amount is equal to, you have to find out the amount, n plus and compound interest. So for finding out the compound interest, you need the amount. So first we'll find out the amount. Amount is equal to principal 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. Principal here is 10,000. 1 plus r is 5 upon 100 to the power 3. 5 ones are, 5 twos are. Okay. So this you will get 21 upon 20 whole power 3. So again you will get 10,000 into 21 upon 20 into 21 upon 20 into 21 upon 20. This 0, this 0, this 0 all will get cancelled. 2 1s are 2 5s are. So after solving this, the amount you will get is 11576.25. This is the amount. Okay. And you know what is compound interest? Compound interest is equal to amount plus principal. So amount is 11576.25. What is the principal here? That is 10,000. So on adding this, you will get 15762.15765. This is the compound interest. This is the compound interest, and this is amount for half yearly. Now what we have to see? We have to see the difference. For this, we have taken it for half yearly, we will take out it for annually. So for annually, I'm writing it here. Annually, the principal will be equal to how much? 10,000. Time here it is given how much? 1.5 years. Year rate is equal to how much? 10%. Okay. As I have told you, when time is given in 1.5 years, so for the first year we take out the compound interest, and for the half year we take out the. Else you have taken out the principal, time, rate, and time is first we will take out for 1 year and then we will take out for half year. So here I am taking out for 1 year. 1 year is equal to amount you will get. P 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. Okay, so amount will be, what is the principal here? 10,000 into 1 plus R is 10 upon 100 to the power 1. This 0 and this 0 will get cancelled. This will be 11 upon 10 to the power 1. This 0 and this 0 will cancel, and this will be 11000. This is for 1 year. Now we have to take out the simple interest. So simple interest for half year. Half years, simple interest is equal to P into R into T upon 100. So as you know, we have to find out the simple interest here. So for the principal for this, you know, the principal, new principal will be for this half yearly. You know that we will not take the original principal year. We will take the amount which we got here after 1 year. So the principal year will be 11,000 into rate is how much? 10% and time is half year. Multiplied by 100. Okay, P into R into T upon 100. This 0 gets cancelled, this 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. 2 1s are, and this is 2 5s are 10. So from here you will get 550 as the simple interest. You will get 550 at the simple interest. Okay, now what you have to find out? You have to find out the compound interest. So first we will find out the total amount. So total amount is equal to how much? 11,000. So amount here is, total amount is 11,550 minus principal here it is given as 10,000. So on solving this you will get 1550 as the compound interest. So what you have to find out, which compound interest was greater for half yearly or for the annually. So here you can see half yearly compound interest is this and annually compound interest is this. So you have to find out which one is the greater. So which one is the greater? From here you can see half yearly is the greater. He has to pay more interest as calculated annually. This is question number 9. In this question it says find amount which Ram will get on ₹4096 if he gave it for 18 months at 12% rate, 12.5% rate per annum, interest being compounded half yearly. You have to find out the amount. So for here, principal year it is given as 4096. Time here it is given 18 month. 18 month means 1 year and 6 month. So I can write down this as 1.5 year. Okay, as it is given compounded half yearly, so you know in compounded half yearly what we do, this will be 3 by 2 years. So here we multiplied by 2, so this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled and I will get time as 3 years. Now what is given, rate it is given as 12.5%. Okay, so from here you will get 25 by 2. In rate you know we multiply it, we divide it by 2. So this will be divided by 2. So this will be 25 by 2 into 1 by 2. If this is division, if it will go in multiplication, it will become 1 by 2. So this is 25 by 4. So the new time it will be 3 years and rate it will be 25 by 4. What do you have to calculate? You have to calculate the amount. So amount is equal to principal 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. What is the principal here? It is given as 4096. 1 plus r, you have taken it out, 25 by 4 into 100 to the power. How much? 3. So this will be 25 4s. So this will be 4096 into 1 upon 1 plus 1 upon 4, 4 is 16. So from here you will get 4096 into 16 upon 17 on taking the LCM to the power 3. From here you will get 4096 into 17 upon 16 into 17 upon 16 into 17 upon 16. So on solving this, the amount you will get is 194913. So on solving this, you will get the amount here as 4913. And that's what the question it is asking. Find the amount which Ram will get if he gave it for the 18 months. So the amount is 4913. This is the answer. This is question number 12. In this question it says a scooter was bought as ₹42,000. Its value depreciated at the rate of 8%. Here the word depreciated is there. Depreciated means suppose you have purchased a scooter and you go on using that scooter, then the value of the scooter will be decreased. So here depreciation means decrease in the value of the scooter. At the rate of 8% per annum, and what you have to find the value after 1 year. Suppose I have bought a scooter this year, means 2020, and after 1 year, what will be the value of this scooter? Means I will use it for 1 year. So the value of the scooter, the engine, it will be means being used, so the value will be decreasing. So depreciated means decrease in that value. So we have to find out what will be the value after 1 year. So here principal you are given with 42,000 rupees, rate it is given as 8%, time here it is given as 1 year. So what you have to find out, you have to find out the you have to find out the amount there. So amount is equal to principal 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. This is the amount, this is the basic formula which we use in the amount. But you know, as the value is depreciated here, so instead of plus, you will write down here as minus, because the value of, because the product which we are, which is bought, means scooter, it is bought, it will be used, it will be using, so the value will be decreasing. So because of this, we will write here subtraction. Now we will find out the value. Principal is 42,000, 1 minus 8 upon 100 to the power 1. Okay, solve this, this zero, sorry. First solve this. You will get 42,000 into 100 upon 100 minus 8 to the power 1. Okay, from here you will get 42,000. 100 minus 8 is 92 upon 100. This zero gets cancelled. So the amount you will get on solving this is this much rupee. So this will be the value of the scooter after 1 year. Maybe 1 year.